Hi students, welcome to the another session of our 6th class. That is, as per the syllabus which is concerned, which is given in index page, as per that if you go, we have to go with the November portion. That's next lesson that we have to discuss. But as per the index, if you see, after plants and parts and functions, the next lesson is changes around us, that is for the November portion. So as we are ahead of 1 month ahead, just I am going back to the October portion that I am going to start, that is habitat that we are discussing here. Of course, materials and things also we have. After completion of habitats, we go with the materials and things to cover that. Okay, today we are going to see the lesson habitat. What is mean by habitat? Okay, and what is the meaning of the habitat? What are the habitats of different living organisms or living beings which are present in our on land? How they will be? How different places are being selected as habitats for some living beings? That's what, how they are going to select that organism or select that place as their respective habitat. We are going to discuss in detail all the things. And how, if I select a pond, how that pond is considered as habitat at different levels. If I consider a tree, how many type of living beings can have their life existence or shelter on the tree, and how they are considering the tree as their habitats. This small a detailed information we are going to discuss in this chapter. That is chapter number 6, habitat, the first part of this. Part 1, that what we are going to discuss. Okay? Of course, as it is an August portion, we are going back to the August. The note should be continuation how we are going to teach after completion of writing the notes of plants and the parts and functions, you have to start the notes of writing habitats. Okay, that instruction will be given as WhatsApp message. Okay, now let's see what is a habitat is. See, what is the definition of habitat? That's what I want to write on the board, so that it will be easy for you. The surroundings which meets the needs, which meets the need like food, water, air, and shelter. Shelter of a particular organism. The best manner is considered as the habitat fire. In simple, if you talk, habitat is in simple words, if I say habitat, it is a place where it's habitat is a place where fulfill the required needs for life existence. Okay, habitat is a place where it fulfills the required needs for life existence. That place where we are able to get food. Required needs is nothing but food, water, a sufficient amount of air should be there present, and there should be a proper shelter which is going to protect from different atmospheric changes, and there is adequate food we should get, adequate amount of the necessary amount of water we'll get, how much it is necessary, there is a accessibility of air should be present, and the shelter also should be there. That particular region or place where all these required needs are going to meet, that particular place is considered as, or that particular surroundings is considered as habitat of a respective living organism or living being. Okay, suppose for example, have you understood the definition? Of course, look like big, it is smaller. It is the surrounding which meets the needs, like, okay, the surroundings which are there around us, which are going to meet the needs like food, water, we should get sufficient amount of food, if you get sufficient amount of water should be there, and sufficient amount of air should be there, and there is a shelter which is going to protect from the different weather conditions. We should have the proper shelter, protective shelter should be there. Okay, of a particular organism, of any living organism, any living being. Okay, in the best manner. Okay, this all need should be fulfilled in the best manner is considered as the habitat for that organism. Okay. Now, in simple, the place where it fulfills the required needs for life existence, the place where the life of a respective living being can live its life comfortably, that place is considered as habitat. For example, the pond is the habitat for fish. Okay, pond is the habitat for fish. Why? Fish can get adequate amount of food, it's how much it requires, it gets sufficient amount of water, how much it requires, sufficient amount of air it gets, how much it is required, and sufficient amount, it has the respective shelter, the fish has its respective shelter in the pond. Okay, that means as it is fulfilling all the required needs for the existence of the life of that fish, that habitat of the fish can be considered as pond. Our pond is considered as the habitat of the fish. Okay. Now birds, if I say birds live on trees. Where does the bird live? They live on trees. So they are the habitats of the birds. So trees are the habitats of birds, where they have, birds can have the food, and they can have, on trees they might not have the water, but on surroundings nearby they can get it from air, will be the proper shelter will be present on the tree for the birds. They have their respective food, they can collect and store there. The water, the surroundings they can have, the nearby trees they might have the required amount of water, the plenty of water, air will be available which is required for those life existence of the bird. That means, in short, wherever is the place that we select as an habitat for ourselves, it should fulfill, the surroundings should have the proper amount of food, that water, how much we require, it should have the proper amount of water, how much we require, and that respective place should have the sufficient amount of air, how much we require, and it should have the protection, shelter, the place should give the protection to us. Okay, proper shelter should be there, and as these are considered as minimum requirements for the life existence, and the place which is supporting these all minimum requirements, that place can be considered as habitat of us. Okay, now habitat is a place for plants, and animals that gives them optimum conditions for life. Okay, to lead the life of those living beings or living organisms, whatever the required needs are there, if they are giving or if they are supporting those, if that place is supporting those minimum required needs, that place can be considered as the habitat of that organism. Okay, I hope you understood this definition, what is the habitat and examples of that. We will have more analyzation here. Before this, we have a small reading and understanding session we have, so that you can get some more clarity or some more idea about what is habitat is. Uma was swimming in a village pond with her elder brother. Okay, consider this as the figure number one as Uma, and she was swimming with her elder brother. She enjoyed swimming there as she saw several things in the pond different from what she could see around her home. While she was swimming, she was seeing so many different things she was able to observe in the pond where she was not able to observe near her house, okay, or around her house. Her brother would show her eggs of all sort of creatures. Okay, his brother is showing the eggs of all sort of creatures. Right below the lotus leaves was the snail's eggs. Okay, just below, he is showing that the elder brother is showing just below the leaf of the lotus, there are small eggs of snails with leafy brushes. At the side of the pond were eggs of fish and some much more. Okay, see, within the leafy bushes at the side of the pond were the eggs of fish and much more. Pond consists of leafy bushes at the branches of the pond. Nearby that leafy bushes, his brother able to see the eggs of fish and some other creatures, some other living organisms. Okay, there are several organisms vary. Okay, there were several organisms which are vary from small, very small to quite large one, like fish that grandpa was rearing. Okay, human beings would often hold their breath underwater for such exploration, but we would gasp for breath just after a short time and come to the surface. Okay, human beings can be the life existence of the human being underwater can be for few minutes. Okay, so to get the breath, that human being should come to the surface of the pond. We can't live under the water. Okay, only few minutes survival can be possible by the human beings under the water, where we can't live much time under the water. Okay, to get the breath, we have to come up. Okay, Uma often wondered how the organisms underwater could live there easily while it was difficult for her to breathe. See, some other organisms can live underwater, where for us it is difficult to have the breathe underwater. What is the difference? Uma was wondering. Okay, do all organisms have different needs which are fulfilled by their surroundings? Okay, fulfill is F-U-L-F-I-L-L-S, fulfills, that is a, okay. Do all organisms have different needs which are fulfilled by their surroundings? Yes, we can say we have that. Okay. Now see some organisms living everywhere around us. We see them living on the ground, under the ground, in water, on the surface, etc. Okay. Around us we live some. We can see some organisms which are living under the water, or we can see some organisms are living on the ground. Under the ground, they live. Some organisms will live under the ground. Some organisms live in the water. Some organisms live on the surface of. On the surface of water. Okay, organisms can live on the ground or on the surface of the ground or under the ground. Some organisms can live. Some organisms can live in the water, or some organisms can live on the surface of the water. These are okay. Let us explore all the places where organisms, plants, and animals live. Okay, let's try to explore where the plants and animals are going to live. Let us explore our discussion. To do this, to have this, we have to do one activity. Activity 1 has been suggested. Who lives where? Okay. Who lives where is organism? To do this, visit the pond lake in the presence of a teacher or parent only. You have to visit a small lake or pond in the presence of a teacher or elder, and we have to see who is living where. Okay. Here is a list of some organisms. Okay. From that, what we have, we are going to take ant, human beings. We have ant, human beings, elephant, lotus, wall spider, and oyster. Okay. Oyster is one type of fish. Oyster is one type of fish. Rabbit, that we know, bees, any honey bee or something, bees, sparrow, okay, dung beetles, which the insects which is present in the dung, cow dung or what dung we have, earthworms, Corramino, it is one type of fish. It's also one type of fish that we call as murrel, and squirrels, rats, crab, snail, bat, Pistia is aquatic. It's an aquatic plant. That is, a plant leaves, the plant grows, and that is, plant grows in water. Okay. Pistia is aquatic plant, that is, the plant grows in water. We have to take that. And water hyacinth is an aquatic flower, actually. Okay, water hyacinth is an aquatic flower. That is, aquatic flower is flower grows in water. The flower which grows in water is called as water hyacinth. Oyster is one type of fish. Pistia is one type of aquatic plant. Water hyacinth is one type of aquatic flower. Okay. Monkey, prawns, that we call as royalu. Okay. Tiger prawns. And for this list, we have to add frog also. Okay. Frog is one special notation we have for that. You add frog for this list also. You may add the names of even more animals and plants that you see around you You can add more. You add the list. For this list, you add frog or remove those from the given list which are unfamiliar to you. Okay, which among these which are not familiar to us, we can remove that also. Where each organisms found most often, in table number 1, write the names of the organisms in appropriate box. According to where they can be found, you could put the name of one organism in more than one column also. Okay, if you want, we can put one same type. See, suppose if I take the frog, it lives on the ground and in and on the water. Both it will have the place. Okay, if you put the organisms in the column of some other place, if you write in some other place, where does they live that we have to mention? Okay, some examples are filled, and in page number 54, table number 1, we have that column. We have that is under the ground, on the ground, in or on the water, or some other place. And rather than these columns, some other place if they live, where does they live? That what it is being given. And copy the table in the notes. Try to enrich the list as much as you can. Okay, that you have to write this table. You fill it. Then whenever I suggest to write the homework as which is given in the WhatsApp, then you enhance it. You can extend this. Okay, which column? Suppose I'm writing this. Suppose we're able to write snake. Already given snake is being given. Snake where? First we'll fill under the ground. Under the ground segment will fill under the ground segment. What snake can have, earthworms can have, ant can have, under the ground we can have rats, crabs, okay, dung beetle can have under the ground. Okay, on the ground column, if you write real is on the ground column, snake already is given, frog also can be there, rats, ants, human beings will be there on the ground, elephants, bees, squirrels, snails, bats, monkeys, these all are present on the grounds. Okay, now in and on the water, who will be that organisms will live on the ground, and it's going to live in and on the water also, it can live. Okay, snake can live in or on the water, it can live. Frog, lotus, corvino. Just now we have discussed about oyster is one type of fish also. Oyster is also going to live there, and pistia, as it is an aquatic plant which is growing under, pistia can also have, and we have corvino, that is morel, and crabs, snails, water hyacinth can also live. That France royal can have, tiger France also can have, in or on water column we can write. We can extend the table while writing in the notes. Some other place, if I say some other place, some we have birds live on trees, squirrel on trees, sparrow can live in respective home, it will live sparrow. That's what it is being given. It is some help for filling this table 1 from page number 54. In which column will you put a frog? In which column did we put a frog? In 2. On the ground column we can add the frog, and in or on water we can add the frog. That means frog can live on the ground or in or on water. Okay. We have seen that different organisms live in different places, but many of them live in the same place. Living organisms have different needs. They usually stay in one place where most of their needs are met. Okay, one living organisms choose some particular place to have their life existence because they get their needs get fulfilled at that place. okay, most of their needs are going to be met. Okay, whatever the needs are there for them, if their needs are going to met, they choose that place as their living habitat. Okay, that is they get sufficient. What are the needs? That is they get sufficient food. The place, from the place they should get sufficient food, shelters, and other conditions necessary for life. Whatever the other conditions which are necessary for life, if they are getting those needs, they choose, that living organism choose that place as its habitat. Okay, all organisms depend on their surroundings for their needs like food, water, air, and shelter. That's what we have discussed in our definition. And the surroundings which meet the needs of a particular organism in the best manner is habitat of that organism. For example, pond is the habitat of Royalu or the freshwater fran. Okay, fish lives in ponds, so it is a habitat for fish as well. Okay, pond is a habitat for fish as well. Can you say what is the habitat for crow? What is the habitat for crow? A crow makes its nest on the trees, so tree is a habitat for crow. So we often find some insects on the skin of the buffalo. So skin of the buffalo is also habitat for that. Okay, see, crow is living on trees. We can say that crow tree is the habitat of that. Squirrels will live on tree. All type of birds live on tree. So tree is considered as habitat of all the birds. Okay, buffalo, as some insects are living on the skin of the buffalo, that the skin of the buffalo is considered as the habitat of the respective insects. Okay, with such a lot of different type of organisms, it is difficult to find area with just one type of plant or animal. It is also difficult to study the needs of each organism separately. So usually we study them collectively according to the habitat. Okay, what happens? Studying about all organisms, we have plenty n number of living beings present on the earth. So studying about each and every respective organisms and about that respective habitat is difficult. So we group some organisms as a collective group, and about that group we will read what are their needs and what is the habitat. We will make all them as some other living organisms as a group, and we will going to read about what are their needs and what is the respective habitat of that. Okay, I hope you understood what is the habitat, and you have to fill the table which is been given in page number 54 and table number 1, that you have to fill according to the list which is been given in 53 stanza. Based on the 53 stanza, this 53 stanza activity 1, under activity 1, this first paragraph consists of different living organisms. Where does they live? You have to write, add the frog to that list that already I have told. Just enhance this table so that you will get some extra information. I hope you understood this. We will continue in the next session. Thank you. Have a nice day.